I feel like the other thing that's a bit stressful about this is it really feels like you can't even blink. It's like if you even blink when you're doing this, you're gonna miss oncoming traffic or cross traffic or something like that. Like, there's no margin for error in this event, which is just way too stressful and annoying for this early in the game. Like, nobody wants to have to deal with this at this point. So let's see. Okay, there was a checkpoint there, which is why I have to actually make these turns. Yeah, that's smart. That's good. And that's how you know there's not, you're not supposed to be taking a shortcut. That's like, I'm actually kind of okay with the... Because otherwise I would have had this nagging feeling like, am I supposed to be cutting through the park? I don't want to cut through the park, but is that how you're supposed to win this? Oh my god, trucks. Okay, seriously, how many oncoming vehicles are you going to throw at me? Are you just going to keep throwing them at me until I wreck? Is that how this works, game? Seriously. I mean, what the hell? That was ridiculous, right? I'm not crazy. I'm not out of line, am I? That was ridiculous. That was, hey, you might actually win this, so let's destroy your hope of ever existing or doing anything cool ever again. What the hell, game? What the hell? I'm still not catching this guy, even after all that. Like, he should just pull over and be like, dude, you just got past 64 trucks. I'm going to just pull over and let you have it. I think he just took a shortcut. I think that's what happened. Oh my god, seriously? Did he get hit by cross traffic? I don't even know what happened there. That's another one where I'm gonna have to watch the bot. Okay, I think I actually might have this time. I'm not gonna do anything too crazy. Final stretch. Whew. Man, that was annoying as hell. Let me tell you, that was annoying. I feel like that was a glitch or something, honestly, where he just like disappeared. It was like he was trying to take a shortcut or something and it didn't work and he got hit, and then I got distracted trying to figure out what happened there, but fortunately it didn't cost me the race. And that's another one where I'm really going to have to go back and look at this and see how that actually looked, because it's so hard to figure out sometimes what's actually happening, because you only have a split second to see what's going on, and then you have to go with your brain's like first interpretation of it and assume that that's correct. But I'm sure when I watch the video back, I'll see all kinds of stuff that I didn't notice when it was actually happening. That is bonkers, though. Holy crap.
I see you around here again. I'll take a lot more than your territory. Get me?
Whew, man. It's like I need a nap after that. That was crazy. I just want to drive around for a little bit, honestly, and chill out. Ah, stop challenging me! Well, I did say I was going to do this later. That is a thing that happened. I don't think there's any way I can do that from a dead stop, though. Oh, okay. It's gonna let me back up a little bit. That's that. I find that that's the key to these jumps and stuff. Like, you want to get a little bit more of a running start than what they want to set you up for. That was a mistake. So that's another thing about the game that's kind of annoying, is the cops. The cops are really hard to get away from. And like, in a way that's just not fun. Like, they like magnetize to your car, basically. And like, otherwise, just... it's kind of hard to describe, but basically, like, anytime they hit you, they bring you to a dead stop. Like, once you hit into them, it's like you're magnetized to them and can't pull away. Like, they only give you a second or two to get away once you come into contact with them, or else it's over. Like, I get that they want to make it difficult and challenging to get away from the cops, but at the same time, I think they take it a little far. See what I mean? They're like, backing up makes a huge difference. Parts. What's weird is, like, if I were to abort that, it would just leave me in the world exactly where I was, but for some reason when I hit continue, it fades to black and resets me where I was. And I'm not sure what the difference is there, but it's kind of weird. Okay, so now that the stress and annoyance of that event is over, let's talk more objectively about the game as a whole. I do think this is an awesome game, like, from what I have played of it so far. Like, just the open world, like, driving around stuff like this, like, finding the car parts or doing, like, the random challenges and just kind of exploring the, like, huge environment that they've created here is all, like, super awesome. And as a fan of games like Test Drive Unlimited that are, you know, more of this open world kind of style of driving, like, this is an amazing kind of representation of that concept. Like, it's basically that Test Drive Unlimited concept, but, like, taken to a much higher level of production, where it's like, everything looks amazing, and it's just super cool and fun. Like, you know, obviously, I just spent however long I just spent grinding through that story mission, and that was super not fun. But, you know, I don't think, even that being really, really annoying, I don't think is enough to, like, detract from the overall, you know, experience of the game, which I think is quite good. At least based on what I've seen so far. I mean, it's definitely cool. It's definitely a cool game. So I'm, like, following this ambulance, because it's got its lights on. So the cool thing about that is it's kind of clearing up the path. I did not mean to do that. I was following perhaps a bit too closely. Okay, so there are the cops chasing me. And rightfully so, because, well, I just rear-ended an ambulance. Let's see if I can get away. Let's take an exit. But I love the fact that there's just all this wide open territory, you know, to explore and just drive around in and get into, like, mayhem, basically. Ooh. Pigs. I hear pigs. Oh, wait. It's around here somewhere. Unless that was part of the song, but that sounded like the ping. Thank you. Yep, there it is. Interest I could grab. Cool. Let's maybe try to follow this dirt road. That actually seems to be fading in this direction. Somewhere. Maybe over here. Oh wait, I think this is it. Those are actual cars, those aren't wrecked cars. It's not a wreck. It was like it was back here in the field or something. I think it's here. Wait. Oh yeah, it's in that. I can see it. It's in that structure there. Just gotta figure out how to get into it. See, maybe on the other side. That was a tricky one. They actually stuck it in a building, like in a structure. Heap. Okay. All right. Well, I think that may be enough of this. I think I've shown a pretty good chunk of it. A little bit bummed out that the story mission I happened to play, neither one of them was particularly great. But you know, it's still early in the game. Hopefully that one is not indicative of a trend in the game design. I mean, I played through probably a dozen or so story missions prior to that one, and they all were, you know, pretty doable. Like maybe they took like, I don't know, 3 or 4 attempts to get down. Like a lot of them went more like that chase scene did than that race. And I don't know. I mean, maybe it'll just be a case of as I get better cars and improve the car that I have, those will just become less of an issue. Like maybe I'm just in a weird spot where I haven't upgraded my car enough, or I don't have a good enough car to be progressing the story. Like maybe I should work on updating that stuff a little bit. But honestly, my big problem with this game is I just have a tendency to get distracted with it and just start driving around and exploring, because I actually feel like that's one of the most compelling parts of the game, is just this, having this huge world to just drive around in and just go up onto a hill and look around and see what you can see. You know, like there's something just neat about that that I really appreciate. Oh look, balloons. See? That's what I like. Nice happy clouds and balloons and stuff. Here. There, look at that. Nice ambient techno playing in the background. Happy. Happy. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for from this game. But more of that. Less of being stressed the hell out. Just gonna chill out here in this wheat field with Gordon Freeman and his Nissan. Watch some balloons. Just enjoy life. Yes. Yes. Yes! Wheat field donuts! So yeah, that's the crew. Hope you guys have enjoyed this. Hope this gives you an idea of whether or not this game is right for you. I think it's pretty cool, despite some of the issues I've been having with it. Fortunately, none of those issues have been technical in nature, other than the server stuff, which, I mean, it's launch day. You're going to have server issues. That's not surprising. They're, like, amazing. And it does seem to have worked itself out here. I mean, I've been playing for a while since that last server glitch, so hopefully that's a indication that things are on the right path. But I think for now, I'm going to call it, and yeah, see what other kind of adventures I can get into later. But until next time, the crew.